Welcome students in the organic chemistry lecture series. Today in this video we are going to start our new topic, that is chemistry of aliphatic hydrocarbons, which is in semester 2 and chemistry paper 1 first year BSc. Now the first point of your syllabus is the carbon-carbon bond formation reactions. Carbon-carbon bond formation reaction. Okay, now in this we have to study about the chemistry of alkanes, or you can say formation of alkanes. Formation of alkanes. You know that alkanes are the saturated hydrocarbons. Okay, for example, you know the simplest alkane, that is methane, then CH3, CH3, that is ethane, propane, and so on. Okay, so we have to study the formation of alkanes, by which reactions we can form alkanes, that we have to study. So there are two reactions in your syllabus. There are two reactions in your syllabus by which we can form alkanes. By which we can form alkanes. Okay. So which two reactions are there? The first reaction is Roots reaction. Roots reaction. This reaction I think you have studied in your lower classes, that is 12th and 11th class. Again, another reaction is Roots-Fittig reaction. Fittig reaction. So today in this video we are going to study these two reactions one by one. So just remember that the carbon-carbon bond formation reactions we are going to study, and that is about formation of alkanes. Okay. There are two reactions by which we can form alkanes. One is Roots reaction and another one is Roots-Fittig reaction. So we'll study one by one. Okay, first of all we will study about the Roots reaction. It is nothing but the coupling of alkyl halides with sodium metal in presence of dry ether to form hydrocarbon. So what is Roots reaction? It is simply the coupling of two things. First thing is alkyl halide, coupling of alkyl halides with sodium metal, with sodium metal. Okay, and this takes place in presence of dry ether. Remember, in presence of dry ether. To form hydrocarbons, that is alkanes. To form hydrocarbons, or we call it as a alkane, is known as Roots reaction. Okay, Root reaction. This reaction was discovered by the scientist Roots, therefore this is called as Roots reaction. Okay, so two things we have to remember. The one is alkyl halide and another one is sodium metal. Okay, so reaction between alkyl halide and sodium metal in presence of dry ether to form hydrocarbon. So this is known as Roots reaction. So it is very simple. I think in your lower classes, that is 11th class and 12th class, you might have studied this reaction. So it is a very simple reaction. So what is alkyl halide? Alkyl halide is nothing but compounds having functional group RX. Okay, RX, where this X is halogen. Okay, I will write here where X is what? Halogen. Halogen means fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, like this. Okay, so RX plus sodium metal. Okay, the reaction between alkyl halide and sodium metal in presence of what? What is on this arrow? There is a dry ether to form hydrocarbons. So hydrocarbons are formed there. Plus side product is 2NaX. So here we have to balance this reaction. So we have to take 2 moles of alkyl halide as well as 2 moles of this sodium. Okay. So this is the general roots reaction. Okay. So reaction between alkyl halide, I will write here alkyl halide, and this is sodium metal. Sodium metal, this is higher hydrocarbons, or we can say alkane. Okay, so this is the general roots reaction. Now if you use here different alkyl groups then and different halogens, you will get different products. Okay, so this is the basic reaction: 2 moles of alkyl halides plus 2 moles of sodium metal in presence of dry ether couples to form a higher alkane. So the reaction is known as roots reaction. So I will take one example of this reaction so that you will understand this reaction. So I will take 2CH3I, that is methyl iodide, plus 2Na. There is a formation of, I will write reagent here, dry ether. There is a formation. What will be the product? Product will be CH3 plus 2NaI. So see here, from methyl iodide and a sodium metal, there is a formation of ethane. So you will notice here that there is a formation of higher alkanes. That means see here is one carbon, but here is two carbon, so we get higher alkanes. This reaction results in the formation of symmetrical alkanes. Remember, this is very important thing. Okay, so this ethane is symmetrical, that means even number of carbon atoms is there. So this is called as roots reaction. Now we'll see some few points of this reaction further. So the most important point which we have noticed here is that this reaction forms symmetrical alkanes. Remember this is very important. Or we can say a product with even number of carbon atom, even number of carbon atoms. Okay, now you have you know that 2 moles of alkyl halides we have used. Now sometimes what happens if we use different 2 different alkyl halides, then what happens? Suppose 2 different alkyl halides we have used, one is Rx and another one is R dash X, and then take sodium metal, okay, and in presence of dry ether, there is a formation of a mixture of alkanes. Je aplyala RR or R dash R dash or R and R dash. So these 3 types of alkanes we can get as a product. So we get a mixture of alkanes. So you remember this mixture of alkanes. When this is possible? When we use 3 different type of alkyl halides. Sorry, 2 different types of alkyl halides. If we use 2 different types of alkyl halides, then we get a mixture of alkanes. So this is the drawback of this reaction, we can say. Okay. So when 2 different alkyl halides are used, a mixture of alkane is obtained, and which is very difficult to separate. Hence, this is the drawback of this reaction, and yield is also poor. Another example which you have to study is that if we take cyclic starting material, this is very famous example. Remember, this is always asked in examination. So if you take this type of alkyl halide in presence of sodium and ether, so what will be the product? So product will be simply this compound. Okay, so this is bicyclo. The name of this product is bicyclo 1.1.0 butane. Okay, so this is the important example. Remember, you can consider this as one alkyl halide, this as another alkyl halide. You know, there is a coupling between two alkyl halides, so we'll get this product. Okay, so this is about Roots reaction. Now we will study about Roots-Wittig reaction. Okay, now we will see about Roots-Wittig reaction. It is just a modification of Roots reaction which have made by this scientist Wittig along with Roots. So what is Roots-Wittig reaction? It is a reaction between aryl halide and alkyl halide. It is the reaction between aryl halide and alkyl halide. Okay, that means the reaction between aryl halide and alkyl. Aryl halide means aromatic ring is there, and alkyl means simple alkyl group is there. Okay, so this reaction also takes place in presence of sodium metal and will get alkylated aromatic ring. Okay, so I will take one example so that you will easily understood. So take this bromo benzene. This is aryl halide. Okay, because aromatic ring is there. Plus if we take now suppose alkyl halide C4 H9Br in presence of sodium and ether, what is the product? There is a formation of this product. That means both alkyl, aryl and alkyl groups combines or couples together to form the product. So we get this product 2NaBr. Okay, so this is the Roots-Wittig reaction. That means this is the modification of Roots reaction, we can say. So what is the general Roots-Wittig reaction? We can write general Roots-Wittig reaction. Consider this as a alkyl halide, consider this as a aryl halide, and in presence of sodium and ether we get this product R plus 2NaBr. Okay, so this is the Roots-Wittig reaction. So this is second reaction which we have studied today. So I will summarize finally what part we have taken today. So in summary, what we have seen, we have started the chemistry of aliphatic compounds, chemistry of aliphatic hydrocarbons, a new topic of your chemistry paper 1 semester 2. In this we have seen the two reaction. The one is Roots reaction, and another reaction which we have studied today is Roots-Wittig reaction. Okay, so both these reactions are a reaction in which alkanes are formed. Okay, so what is the product? Product is alkane in both these reactions. So we can say that these are the carbon-carbon bond formation reactions. So I hope you have understood this. In further lecture, we will study about the reactions of alkanes. So this will study in the further lecture. So tab tak ke liye hum yahan rukte hain. So watch this video and learn from the examples of your books. So we'll stop here. Thank you. Have a nice day.